Consider the system of linear equations given by AX equal to B, where A is this matrix given here, and B is this tuple, 4, 5, 6. Notice that A is already in reduced row echelon form, and it has no row of zeros, so the system has at least one solution. And to quickly get a solution, notice that the first and third and fourth columns are the pivot columns, so we can set x1 to 4, x3 to 5, and x4 to 6, and x2 and x5 to 0. That will give you a solution to the system. But since we have two free variables, namely x2 and x5, there are going to be infinitely many solutions. Is there a succinct way to describe all the solutions? To do that, what you want to do is you set each of the free variable to a parameter. Say we set x2 to s and x5 to t, where s and t can be any real numbers in this case. Then the system reduces to following. So 2 times x2 becomes 2 times s, and minus 1 times x5, that becomes minus t, and the right hand side is 4. For the second equation, we have x3 plus 2t equal to 5, and for the third equation, we get x4 plus 3t equal to 6. So if you solve for x1, x3, and x4 in terms of s and t, what you get is x1 equal to 4 minus 2s plus t, x3 equals 5 minus 2t, and x4 equals 6 minus 3t. Now we can write the solution in the form of a tuple. So x1, x2, x3, x4, and x5 can be written as, so x1 is 4 minus 2s plus t, x2 is s, x3 is 5 minus 2t, x4 is 6 minus 3t, and x5 is t. Now, we can rewrite x2 as 0 plus s, and x5 as 0 plus t. Then we can separate things a bit. So I can write this as 4, 0, 5, 6, 0, plus s times minus 2, 1, 0, 0, 0, plus t times 1, 0, minus 2, minus 3, and 1. So the set of all solutions is going to be given by this. So here, s and t can be any real numbers. And that's a succinct description of all the solutions. Now let's look at another example. And this time we're going to define the system over GF2. x1 plus x3 equals 1, and x2 plus x3 equals 0. Now, remember that GF2 is the field with only 0 and 1 as elements, and 1 plus 1 is defined to be 0. All the other operations are as usual. So here, if you look at this system, x3 is a free variable, because if you look at the augmented matrix, this is what you have. So that means we can set x3 to a parameter, and we'll set it to s, so that gives us x1 equal 1 minus x3, but we have no minus 1, so it becomes 1 plus x3, so 1 plus s, and x2 will be just s. And depending on the value of s, which can be only 1 or 0, that will give us two solutions. So if s is 0, we get the solution 1, 0, 0. And if s is 1, we get the solution 0, 1, 1. So here's an example with at least one free variable, but you only get finite number of solutions because we're working over a finite field. And in general, if you have free variables for a system defined over a field with infinite elements, like this one, then you're going to have infinitely many solutions. And that doesn't give us any problem in describing the set of solutions succinctly.